Between the concerning live streams and the obvious substance issues, Leah Marie Johnson has been put through it last year. She lost her boyfriend in July, and there has been so much going on with her life. I am so surprised to see that she has even made it out on the other side. And I have an update for you guys today on Leah, what she's been up to ever since the tragedy that happened in July. So get ready, pay close attention, grab a snack, and wash down with some hot tea, even though this really isn't tea at all. But I do have some good news. You guys may know in the beginning of my YouTube career, I made videos about Leah Marie Johnson. It was the first commentary videos I ever did. If you don't know who Leah Marie Johnson is, she got famous from Kids React Online, which was a really big thing on YouTube in the past, where kids would go on camera on the React channel and they would watch videos and react to it. And it's kind of a weird idea because they would show kids like obviously like inappropriate videos to have them react to it online. And Leah was one of their first batch of kids. The channel is React, and you can actually go to it right now and watch videos of Leah from back in the day. This actually really kicked off her career on YouTube, becoming a YouTuber and then becoming a singer. And she is an amazing singer with a true talent. She's even dropped music this year, which is bomb, but she has also gone through so much other things. Again, if you guys don't know who Leah Marie Johnson is, she is a musician, and I recommend going to listen to DNA, one of her songs that has 20 million views on YouTube. It's really good. It's really telling. And I think it shows you guys who Leah is and some of the reasons why she struggles with substances. Again, guys, I've made tons of videos on Leah in the past. She is someone who I am a fan of and who I was really concerned with and why I brought awareness to this. And I know a lot of people like jumped on the ship whenever, you know, this all went down. And if you look up Leah Marie Johnson online, you'll see videos from, you know, Spill Sash and Jay Aubrey and a ton of other people, which is totally fine. But a lot of people have forgotten about Leah Marie Johnson since everything has happened. And I actually went on a live stream yesterday. You guys can see it in the screenshot on my other channel where I talk about some of the updates I've had for Leah Marie. But now there have been more updates since then, and I am honestly shook. So I'm here to update you guys on what's currently going on with Leah Marie Johnson and the status, because there were so many up and downs in the beginning of this year and last year. Her live streams were really concerning, where she would go on obviously high, say certain things that she wouldn't want to say, and she had, you know, the whole controversy with her record label and making out with the studio guy, and there were so many tragic things, but I really don't want to focus on those, and you can find videos on there if you want to, but I want to update you guys on exactly what's going on with her. So she is popular online. She has 1.3 million followers on Instagram, and she's a celebrity. She's totally a celebrity, even though she's not as popular as a lot of other people, and she's become more quiet over time. We don't really know what she's been up to until recently. Well, this is her main Instagram that is verified and has 1.3 million followers, but she actually does have another Instagram page where she posts, not too often, but it's called Leah Marie Official. And I have confirmed since my live stream yesterday that this is her Instagram. Thank you so much for your donation. I actually found you through talking about Leah. Yes, thank you. A lot of people have, because I started commentary videos because of Leah Marie Johnson. Not because I want to be a commentator or tee people on here or create drama, because I was actually a fan who was concerned, did not know what to do, so I turned to the internet for help. So this is currently her Instagram, and you can see in the bio, "Hey guys, this is my official account until further notice. Rest in peace, my earth angel, Ryan Bowers." And like I mentioned earlier, guys, she has gone through some traumatic things recently. She did lose her boyfriend in July, late July, on July 18th, and he took his own life. He had his own battles with, you know, his demons. He, you know, worked closely with Nick Cannon at some point. He had his own rap career. They have songs together. And it's really, really sad. I actually had several videos I made about Ryan because he wasn't the best influence for Leah, okay? He just wasn't. But I did take them down because I don't want his reputation to be tainted from his behaviors like that, or to have that type of memory. You know, this isn't his legacy, and he does deserve respect, and that's why I took down those videos. And I do really feel bad for Leah and what she has gone through. Her last post on her official Instagram, the newer one, was posted, you know, a few months ago, and she actually mentions in this post that she does not have access to her old Instagram. Like I just showed you guys a second ago, she has an Instagram with 1.3 million followers. You know how many people would love to have that Instagram? Because that's like brand deals already. Like, oh, and if you didn't know about Ryan's passing, I made a video on that. So go watch it on my other channel. It's very sad. I was very emotional. But she has an account with 1.3 million followers, which is a huge deal. But in her post, she claims that she doesn't have access to this page. There's a reason why I think she lost access to her page. And the reason why is because she would go on live stream on Instagram using that account, that main account, and that really got her in trouble. But her boyfriend, Ryan, at the time, really liked going on live stream. And it almost seemed like he maybe pressured her sometimes to go on live stream. So in this little caption, she says, "This is my new account until the account Leah is up and running again." I don't think that her account Leah was ever down. I don't think it's ever been taken down before. And I think that this might actually be a lie. And I really don't want to like come for Leah. I'm not trying to come for Leah at all in this video. But I do think that she's lying to her fans by saying that she lost access to her account. Because there are records online showing that she has been unfollowing people from that account and has been following people. And that wouldn't really make sense if your account was disabled and no one was in it. My theory is that she told her boyfriend and told the public that her Leah account was disabled. I mean, the account kept getting her in trouble with the live streams, with the drama, with her boyfriend, with the record label. So she told everyone that the account's gone. I can't do anything with it. And honestly, if you have an Instagram account with millions of followers and a verification, that is a career right there. And it could be taken away from you so easily. Well, she claims it was taken away from her, but the statistics don't lie. And it looks like she still is following and unfollowing people on there. And I don't know why she would want to hide that or to fool people into thinking that her Instagram is gone. I think it's just because her boyfriend, you know, made her look pretty bad on Instagram at the time, and she didn't really want to do that. Everyone was telling her, yo, stay away, stay away. Well, I haven't really talked about Leah in a minute ever since her boyfriend passed because it has been very sensitive. I want her to relax, to get treatment, to be at peace. But I did recently want to start speaking about her again because I got a weird message on Facebook, guys. And I just a warning, this guy is creepy. So his name is Jason Randall, and I don't think he knows Leah, even though I made a whole video about how he messaged me, because part of me was thinking that he was talking to Leah. This man was not speaking to Leah. He definitely was talking to some bot, and he actually reached out to me on Facebook saying, "Leah Marie Johnson is very happy, and we have been involved for over a year, so leave her alone." I said, shared this to my story. Thanks for the update. If anyone ever DMs me, any celebrities or anything, I just screenshot it, put on my story, because I'm very open with you guys. I always have been. Then he replied later on and said, to make her really happy, more money she needs. I don't know. That part's just confusing me. His grammar is out there. I don't know if it's the UK or what, but hey, UK people, I love you guys. But he claims that she needs money to come to the UK to see him. I really don't think Leah Marie Johnson is coming to the UK to come see this guy. I feel like he's definitely talking to a bot. And some of you guys have actually messaged him since then and were like, hold up, like, he's totally a troll. This is fake. He's not talking to Leah. And I don't think he is talking to Leah. And I can't believe he reached out to me for money for Leah. Like, what? That's not going to help her at all. Going to the UK is not what would help her. So I think that guy is full of crap, and obviously he doesn't know anything. But there are some other updates about Leah that are actually true and factual. Like I told you guys, her Instagram page is official Leah Marie, or Leah Marie official. It's that one page I had up a second ago, and you guys can go follow her there. That is legitimately her account, and people are posting her, tagging her, and she is even appearing in live streams online. Like Charisma, her friend who Agarisma, she went on live and Leah actually popped in the live stream, and she said, "Hi Leah," and it also confirms that Leah is actually using that Instagram page. Well, her friend actually posted a picture of her recently yesterday, which is so weird because I made the live stream and then some people DM'd me and were like, hold up, like Leah's now appearing online. And I'm like, wait, hours after I made a live stream about her? Like, how does this happen? So this account, True Faith, actually posted Leah Marie Johnson with the bandana and says, "You don't need much, just a little faith and trust," and tagged Leah Marie official. So that is a new picture of Leah, and I actually think this picture was taken less than 24 hours ago from this video. There's also a screenshot story thing that was going around of Leah and the recording studio, so I'm assuming new music is coming her way. This is obviously really controversial because everything she has gone through has really like tainted her image and her reputation, but I also feel like it's a great opportunity for her to come back into the limelight and to show us how talented she really is. All of her music, all of her vocals, everything, all her lyrics, everything is so great and amazing, and I really hope this is Liam Ree Johnson's comeback, because if you guys go online and go on the news right now and look up her name, it looks pretty bad, and people really did use her story to make a quick buck. And I just want to show you guys that not only did I make like a lot of videos on Liam Ree Johnson because I was truly concerned, but I am still keeping up to date with Leah because I can't just forget about her. I think about her every single day, and I hope that she is okay and that she is getting treatment for her substance issues, because she does have those issues, and it would be really sad if we were to lose her to those issues, kind of like her boyfriend was lost. So again, I'm sending good vibes to Ryan and his family, and I just want to update you guys with those two pictures of Liam Ree Johnson, because it is crazy. She's back, and I feel like I have missed her. I want to see some new music. I want to see some posts. I just want her to remember how much her fans actually truly care and love her, and they want to see her do well. When people were making those videos in the past about you, and you know, if you go up on YouTube and search it, you can find it. They were, I mean, some were really concerned, but some were just T-channels, and at the time, I didn't realize that because I was like, oh, I don't do this type of stuff. I'm just literally concerned about Liam Ree Johnson. Well, these people still want to see you succeed. And the only reason they made these videos was because they were concerned with what you were doing and your behavior, because you were exhibiting behavior that was dangerous and that was detrimental to your health and risky. And we didn't want you to go down the same road as all your other ex-boyfriends, which has been terrible. Even Ian, and you know, guys know, I don't want to even get Ian involved in this, but he is really bad, and I really hope that he stays far, oh, far, far away from Leah. I do hope that she is doing well and that she's okay, but from the pictures, I feel like this one, for example, is just a little bit weird, like, concerning looking. Like, I don't know. I mean, she has, like, a little, like, mask on, so maybe that's just her face mask because of COVID, but also, she doesn't look really happy. She looks kind of sad. Like, should I even zoom? Let's zoom in on this. I know I hate whenever I do this on camera, but let's zoom in. Like, your girl does not look happy. She looks really, like, actually sad and miserable. But I just want to hope for the best because it's been so much time. And, you know, last time we really talked about her, her boyfriend was passing away. So, I mean, your girl's been going through something. She definitely has PTSD, and I am giving her all the strength I have to push through because she has done so much already that she needs to continue fighting this battle. She looks a little happier in this picture, I have to say. So, I mean, it's not all mean mugs over here. So, I hope she's well, that she's healthy. She looks kind of, I mean, healthy from this picture. She doesn't look like necessarily thin or anything, but obviously it's not a great shot, and she hasn't posted a picture of herself in months. So I hope Liam Ree Johnson is okay at the end of the day, and I will always be here for her, even when Alicia or her other fans have, you know, turned on her, and, you know, being friends with Liam Ree Johnson wasn't cool anymore. I will always be here for Leah, and my DMs are always open because I want to actually get her help and actually have her clean and happy and healthy. There is that Leah deep inside of her. She's just been put through so much. We need to pick her back up, dust her off, and let her, you know, creatively thrive, because that's where she does best. But I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please leave a comment in support of Liam Ree Johnson. I know some of you guys don't really care about Liam Ree Johnson, probably didn't watch this video, but some of you guys do care about her, and you have been OGs from the beginning. So show your support, go follow her on her new page, and let's show her that we will be here for her when she's ready to come back with her new music, which seems like it will be coming quite soon. I'm hype. I'm really hyped. So I'll see you guys in a new video soon. Check me out on Instagram at SL0Friend, and I'll see you guys next time. Bye.